Okay, greetings y'all, Renegade Biker 24 again, and what you're looking at is the G.I. Joe Cobra Crimson Guard. As you can tell here, this is the one I got from Wally World before all this mess started happening. And just wanted to kind of go over a few things with you and before I take it out of its plastic prison. As you can tell here, this looks like an M16. This right here looks like a desert rifle or a desert eagle. This is probably a short sword, and this is probably not a K-bar, but it's something different. And then this is a scabbard or the sword, and then right behind there is the sword holder or the sheath. So I'm gonna take a look here at the back. Now I'm gonna open this because basically it's to the point where you can't really get a good thing on it. So I'm just gonna say that right here on the file card it says Roll, he's a Cobra Elite Trooper. His primary specialty is undercover espionage. His secondary specialty is demolition. His birthplace is various countries. It says the Crimson Guard are the elite shock troops of the Cobra Legions, too precious to be wasted on the battlefield. They are dispersed worldwide in deep cover, assuming normal appearances and lifestyles. And then here you've got the different versions of what this is. I'm going to try and find the elite, or the, I should say the, not elite, but the file card online, so you can probably read it better than this. But I think I have Zartan, now I have him, and I think I have Snake Eyes, I just don't have Storm Shadow. But anyway, let's tear into this guy, and then I'm going to show you the difference between him and the other ones, the classified one and the vintage one. And I'm going to have to try and go in with my X-Acto knife here. So we try to get into him, and he eventually will come out. So all right. I'm going to take him out. And, there goes a stand. Oh, alright. So we're just going to do it this way. Alright. So now, what we have here is the stand. As you can tell here, it's got the Cobra logo on it, and this is what it looks like on the back. All right, so here is his backpack. As you can tell, it looks pretty good. I mean, they even went so far as the detail of the Cobra logo. So it looks pretty good, and it's got the straps here on the back here. So you got that. Now I got his sheath. His sheath here looks pretty good. I mean, it's pretty well straight. And even here on the top part. So Now we are going to go and look at his other accessories. Yep. This is his M16. I know this because I've been doing some research on it. So, but this is the M16. I'm not really sure why they gave the enemy an M16 rifle. But right up here, I don't know if you can see that, but there is a place to put blast effects, but it's very, very small. I had to probably hollow that hole out. Now here is the knife. As you can tell here, this is what it looks like up close. And then the shank, or I should say, yeah, the shank. But that's what it looks like up close. Now, we're going to take out his, probably his gun here, which probably is a Desert Eagle. By the way, so this is what this looks like. Now, if these are not coming out good, please let me know in the comments section. I am shooting this in 4K, and I'm not really sure how well it goes. But this one looks like either a Desert Eagle, or it could be another pistol. But anyway, so that's what I got there. And then I got his sword. His ceremonial sword. So this is his ceremonial sword here. I'm not sure if that's coming out very well or not. But that's what it looks like on that end. That's what it looks like right here. Now, we're going to put his sword in. So I'm going to put his sword in here. So it's ready to go. And then we're going to put that on his backpack like so. And we're going to set that aside. Then we're going to take out the Crimson Guard. But before I do that, I want to get this in here. And I'm going to get him out. Alright, so we got him out here, and then, okay, I'm gonna try to stand him up while I get the card ready. So, and he falls over. Alright, well, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put this together. Now, I'm going to go over this guy because he looks a little bit different than the other ones, as you can tell here. I'm going to try and reduce the light. So you can probably see better. Alright, so he's got a silver mask on. It's not like the regular black one. But anyway, that's what I've got here. Now he's got his torso with the red Cobra insignia. In which, on the vintage one, I have to be really careful so I don't rub this off. So, but his arms go all the way around, like so. And they bend, like so. And then his fingers can snap back. And the same thing on his other arm. Goes all the way around. On this arm, he's got an insignia right there. I guess that means Cobra Elite Troops. Now you can move him that way. And you can move his forearm in. And then you just pull out his fingers and they snap back. Oh. Now, he can kick up that far and kick that far back. You can bend at the knee. And then he can have his boot twisted all the way around. Same thing. You can kick up that far and go back that far. And you can bend at the knee. And you can move his foot or his boot around. You can make his feet go like that. Now this looks like it's a little more detailed, in my opinion. So what I'm going to do is he's got these holsters right here. I don't know if you can see that. You got one right there, it's red, and you have another one here that you could probably put his extra knife in, or you could do the opposite. So you could put the knife in here and the gun in here, but let's see how that works, because it looks like from the picture there that the gun goes in here, so the knife goes in here. So I'm going to put the knife in like so. If I can get it in. Alright, so now his knife is in. And then his pistol, which will go right here. Then put on his backpack. I'm going to put on his backpack. See how well it fits on there. Yeah, it fits on perfectly. It fits on just perfect. Now, put his rifle in his hands. So, you see that, if I can move my big fingers out of the way. So, I'll do that, then I'll put him on his stand here, his Cobra stand. So hopefully he gets on there okay. So yeah, line up the foot peg. Alright, and then line up the other foot peg. Now you got him looking like that. Alright, so I'm going to aim it out like so. And you can see what it looks like. I'm going to turn on the extra light. Let's see here. It is right here. At least I thought it was. All right. Turn it on. So alright, there we go. Now it looks a little better now I shut off this light. And do a little focusing on him. Alright. So that's what he looks like, and I'm going to maybe go down just a tad here. Now, I'm going to do one rotation of him. And I put it right about here. Now, it should be able to go all the way around. Yeah, that's how I figured. Alright, so what I'll do is when it comes around, I am going to aim that. Then I'm going to stop this. Probably put this off to the side here. And then you'll see the difference between him and the vintage one and the classified one. Now, I'm going to show that here. And we're going to try and put this all on this stand here, this acrylic stand. So, we'll take him off here. And we'll put him in the center. Then we'll put the other Crimson Guard. And then this one here, the vintage one. And the vintage one has, looks like it's a dark blue, actually. But I have that, so we're going to take a look at all three of them as I turn on the turntable. You all can see what they look like from different angles. So hopefully none will have a problem here. So that is the Crimson Guard, the Cobra Elite Trooper. As you can tell here, this one looks just like, well, there's a little bit of a difference. I don't know if you can see it, but there is a little bit of a difference. And when it comes to their outfits, as you can tell, they all look almost the same. However, I'm going to stop it right here. You can see that the black right here on the vintage one, right here, looks almost the same as this one. So I'll put him next right there so you can see the difference. You can see that this vintage guy has the black mask. The classified one has the black mask with the the only difference is that this center one right here, the only difference is that center one right there is painted. I don't know if you can see that. Let's see, I'm gonna see if I can try to focus in on that. As you can see, the one there, classified one, and then the vintage one, look almost similar except for the backpack. That's the only difference that I can see between all three of these. So I'm going to try and point that out as I turn it on again. Now, as you can see, there's the black backpack right down there. I should say blue, dark blue. And of course you got the black backpack with the silver insignia. And you have that one there, the red one with the red backpack. And you have this one red with the red backpack. But it looks like it is a little bit different when it comes to that. Now I'm going to try and maybe do an up close and personal one so you can see the difference between them. See, you can see that one right there has the red backpack, and then that one there has a red backpack. Only difference is, if you look at it, this one's got a silver faceplate, but this one has a black silver, or black and a little bit of a silver in the faceplate. That's really the only difference that I can see when it comes to that, in my opinion. So what do you all think of this? Let me know in the comments section below. And next will be me putting it in my Cobra display cabinet, so you all can see that what it looks like with that. Anyway, it's Renegade Biker 24, and I will talk to you all later. Okay, y'all, it's Renegade Biker 24 again. And what you're looking at is my Cobra cabinet. And you see that I have the Crimson Guard from Classified there. I've got Tomax, and then and I have another Crimson Guard right back there. I've got this one here, that's the Walmart one right there. And of course you got the Cobra Troopers and Officers back there. And then I don't know if you can see that, way back there is a bat. And let's see if I can zoom in. Okay, so then you got the bat, and you got some more officer, and then you got trooper. Now over here you have none other than Serpentor. And then there's Baroness, and these are another Cobra, I would say, troopers, because the officers have the silver Cobra insignia. Then you have the Cobra Viper. You have the other Cobra Viper. You have another Cobra Viper back there. And you got another one. You got, that's a trooper right back there. And then you get an Alley Viper back there. And then let's see, that's a Cobra Viper, I would say a commander or a officer right there with the silver and silver faceplate. And then you got a Python Patrol Viper. As you come up here, you get the one Red Ninja, you get the Python Patrol Bat, you get a regular bat, and then there's the Python Patrol Bat after that. And then right up there is a, that's a Red Ninja. Then you get the Alley Viper and Zarana. And then these three back here are Zartan. And then here is the Serpentor, along with Crocmaster and the Baroness. And then another Cobra Trooper, a Alley Viper, Major Blood, and then the Baroness, all throughout there. And then the back row there is none other than Destro. And as you look up here, you see that these are all Storm Shadows. So that's what I have here. And then you get like the ninja, or I can't remember what it was. I have to look back at it. So, and then you get Storm Shadow, and then there's Cobra Commander. And as you can see at the very back there, there's Firefly, Cobra Commander, and then leaning down there is Snake Supreme, Cobra Commander. And then you get the other Royal, the Royal one of Cobra Commander. He's right behind Dr. Mindbender. Then you get the Python Patrol Bat. And you get the regular Bat. Then there is none other than Dr. Mindbender. And then Mr. Banana Man right there. A Python Patrol Officer. So, and then of course there is Firefly's remote control drone. Anyway, that's what I wanted to show you all. And please let me know if it comes out clear or not, because on my computer it always looks fuzzy. I'm not sure why. But please let me know if you can like see the faces clearly, because I'm not really understanding why it is like that on my computer. But anyway, just wanted to show you all that, and then down here with my other things that I've got. Displays, and then there's the Cobra binder. So anyway, y'all, that's all I've got for you for today's vlog. But I wanted y'all to see what it looks like in my display cabinet. Anyway, that's all I've got for you for today. Anyway, it's Renegade Biker 24, and until next time, I will talk to you all later.